Hello everyone. I have quite interesting setup, back to basics. So what I have is a electromagnetic pendulum. As you can see, this string is oscillating between these two points, and you have a coil here. So I can tell you how it basically works. So it's based on a very simple circuit like I show here. So you have a A3144 Hall sensor. So this basically turns on when you pass a magnetic field through it. So when this is turned on, the output is connected to a coil. That's what I show here. It's around 300 turns of 0.15 millimeter diameter. So this is turned on, and it creates a magnetic field. So this is also indicated by this LED, which is connected by 100 ohms to the ground. And since this Hall sensor is has an open collector emitter, so it's connected between collector and emitter, a 220 ohm resistor. So how this works is, once when the magnet, the permanent magnet, passes through the coil, this A3144 sensor detects the magnetic field, and it turns on this coil. Like you see here, the output is connected to the coil. Once this turns on, it's these two, the magnet and the coil, is arranged in such a way that they both have the same pole. So when you have the same magnetic pole, it would repel each other. So in this case, it's south, both are facing south. So when the coil, when the magnet comes from this position to close to the sensor, the coil is triggered. It creates a magnetic field. It creates a south pole here, and you have a south pole here. They would repel each other. So the magnet is pushed to this side. So because of inertia, it would move to some position. And then because of gravity, it would come back. So the sensor is again triggered. It creates a magnetic field here, which is approaches the magnetic field from the permanent magnet, and it pushes on the other side. So this keeps on oscillating. It's quite interesting, and it's a simple setup. But it was quite challenging to make this work, because I have used a flexible thread, as you can see here. So this thread is a simple one, what I show here. If this was a rigid rod, it would have oscillated in the same position. There is no possibility to twist, you know, in directions. But I wanted to make it challenging, so I took a thread. As you can see, even with thread, this would work. I have never seen any video on YouTube or somewhere where people have used a thread, flexible thread. But how this works, or how I made it work, is to take care of this point to make it really rigid. So I used a UV glue here on top, as you can see here. It's a bit out of focus, but as you can see, the few millimeters in the beginning is quite rigid. So I just used a UV glue and cured it to make it rigid there. And this joint where in the bottom also should be quite rigid, at least few millimeters. And the gap between the two has to be also optimized. This is irrespective of what rod you, what kind of string you use here, whether rigid or flexible, this is important. And of course, you have to make sure that this magnet is parallel to the coil. Otherwise, you would have jittering motion, you would have random motion in different directions, because the field is not concentrated and it's not parallel to each other. So you have to take care of that. What is also important in this case is this frame that is connected between the top where the string is held, and also the bottom where the coil, has to be quite rigid. If it is bending, then you would also have this very random moment. So in principle, I use this very simple coil from Conrad. It's 0.15 millimeter diameter. That's what I showed you, and also a coil. And I actually also made a scope measurement to see how this works, and that's what you basically see here. So if I dim the light, you can see that the frequency is around 28 hertz. So there is also a shoot of the voltage in both directions. This is around 8 volts,
And the scale is 2 volts, so the voltage across the coil is around little bit more than 2 volts, let's say. And the on time is around 34-35 milliseconds. Yeah, so it's quite very, very small time period which is in which the coil is turned on. And at the moment it is driven by 5.2 volts, around 5 volts, let's say. And if you lower the voltage, I have seen that this works pretty well up to around 2.5 volts without any problem. But as you can see, the current draw is very, very small. So because the coil is just turned on around 30 milliseconds, so the power consumption is quite low. So in principle, with 3 volt batteries, 2 AA batteries, this would run for months. Yeah. So very, very interesting circuit. You can also see that the LED is being triggered. The LED is getting turned on and off when the magnet passes through the coil. So simple setup, quite interesting concept. I think you can do a lot of things with this, so you can have oscillating circuits based on such a simple setup. Of course, the frequency is quite low, but nevertheless, it's a quite interesting setup. So if you have questions, just pass them on the comments or send me a message. Thank you very much.